Back in the Middle Jurassic time, 166 million years ago, a huge carnivorous animal roamed the Earth. This animal was called Megalosaurus, and it was a great lizard, not just because of how it looked, but also because it was the first dinosaur to be given a name. Imagine what it would have been like when the first Megalosaurus fossil was found in the 1600s. Scientists didn't know about dinosaurs at the time, so they thought it might have come from a Roman war elephant or even a biblical giant. Paleontologists like William Buckland didn't figure out the truth until the early 1800s, when more skeletons were found and studied. In 1824, Buckland gave the Megalosaurus its official name and wrote about it. But not everything he thought he knew about the creature was true. He thought it was a four-legged animal that looked like a snake and could live on land and in the water. He also made it bigger than it was. But as more skeletons of the Megalosaurus were found in the 19th and 20th centuries, we learn more about it. We now know that Megalosaurus only came in one kind, called Megalosaurus buclandi. But the fossil record is still missing vertebrae and head bones, which makes it hard to know what it looked like. In 2010, a geologist tried to figure out what the Megalosaurus looked like by putting together all of its known body parts. Based on these reconstructions, we now know that Megalosaurus was a medium-sized to big carnivorous theropod that was between 20 and 30 feet long and weighed about a ton. Its strong bone structures and big head suggest that it was a strong animal with a very strong skull and long, dagger-like teeth. It probably used its strong, three-fingered arms to grab or slash its food. Even though it wasn't as big as some of its famous relatives, like the T-Rex or Spinosaurus, the Megalosaurus was still one of the biggest theropods of its time. It was a member of the Megalosauridae family, which had nine other ancient members. Megalosaurus lived in what is now England. It and other dinosaurs like sauropods and stegosaurs lived in green, tropical areas. Even though the Megalosaurus was a powerful hunter, it wasn't always easy for it to catch prey. Some examples have bones that are broken, which could mean they had fights with herbivores. It lived with other theropods like Ilioceucus and Streptospondylus, but each species probably had its own niche. The Megalosaurus lived in a world that was full of animals. In the same area, fish, pterosaurs, beetles, and cyanodons all did well. Even though we don't have proof, it's possible that the Megalosaurus hunted these non-dinosaur animals as well. The Megalosaurus is one of the most interesting and important dinosaurs. It was a huge step forward for science when it was found. But it doesn't always get the attention it should in paleo media. Let's hope that changes so we can see the Megalosaurus for how beautiful it is in pop culture. So, thank you for watching, and see you next time.